dear sweet child. That's what I live for. That's what I do. To help poor unfortunate merfolk like yourself. Poor souls with no one else to turn to. I admit that in the past I've been a nasty. They weren't kidding when they called me, well, a witch. But you'll find that nowadays I've mended all my ways, repented, seen the light, and made a switch to yes. And I fortunately know a little magic. It's a talent that I always have possessed. And here lately, please don't laugh, I use it on behalf of the miserable, lonely, and depressed. Pathetic, poor, unfortunate souls in pain, in need. This one longing to be thinner, that one wants to get the girl. Do I help them? Yes, indeed. Those poor, unfortunate souls, so sad, so true. They come flocking to my cauldron, crying spells, Ursula, please, and I help them. Yes, I do. Now it's happened once or twice that someone couldn't pay the price, and I'm afraid I've had to rake across the coals. Yes, I've had the odd complaint, but on the whole I've been a saint to those poor unfortunate souls. Here's the deal. I'll make you a potion that will turn you into a human for 3 days. Got that? 3 days. Now listen, this is important. Before the sun sets on the 3rd day, you've got to get dear old Princey to fall in love with you. Specifically, he's got to kiss you. Not just any kiss, a special kiss, the kiss of true love. And if he does kiss you before the sun sets on the 3rd day, you'll remain human permanently. And if he doesn't, you turn back into a mermaid. And you belong to me.
No, Ariel, don't be stupid. Don't listen to her. She'll...
Have we got a deal?
If I become human, I'll never be with my father or sisters again.
That's right. But you'll have your man.
Life's full of tough choices, isn't it?
Come on, I know you need a little magic. And magic is my specialty du jour. Don't just stand there looking sick. Would I kid you, play a trick? Like I told you, I don't do that anymore. So I think you ought to take my little bargain. Yes, I think you ought to make my little deal. Sure, it's hard to leave your life, but you could be a prince's wife. Why don't you let me take that dream and make it real? Come on, you poor unfortunate soul. Poor child, poor fish. Aren't you glad you brought your problem to a lady you can trust? Won't you let me grant your wish? You poor unfortunate soul, poor sweet, poor dear. Aren't you lucky that I'm ready with a potion and a plan? Aren't you glad you came and asked if I can help you? And I can. When a mermaid comes to Ursula, she always gets her man. You poor unfortunate soul.
We haven't discussed the subject of payment. You know, you can't get something for nothing. But I don't have any.
I'm not asking much. Just a token, really. A trifle. You'll never even miss it. What I want from you is your voice.
My voice?
You got it, sweet cakes. No more talking, singing, zip.
Without my voice, how can I?
You'll have your looks, your pretty face. And don't underestimate the importance of body language. The men up there don't like a lot of blabber. They think a girl who gossips is a bore. Yes, on land it's much preferred for ladies not to say a word. And after all, dear, what is idle prattle for? Come on, then, not all that impressed with conversation. True gentlemen avoid it when they can. But they don't in swoon and fawn on a lady who's withdrawn. It's she who holds her tongue who gets her man. You, poor unfortunate soul. Go ahead, make your choice. I'm a very busy woman and I haven't got all day. It won't cost much, just your voice. You, poor unfortunate soul. It's sad, but true. If you want to cross a bridge, my sweet, you've got to pay the toll. Take a gulp and take a breath and go ahead and sign the scroll. Got some chance and now I've got her. Boys, the boss is on a roll. This poor, unfortunate soul.